with that push comp that they do so well. Fortress Blackfeather from TSM.
You know, this has been coming out of TSM so far all day today. And, you know, Team Secret, they're getting used to this. They're going to make sure they grab a composition that suits them very well. However, Ringo up against Blackfeather, he's definitely going to have a very hard time here.
Yeah, that's very interesting that they would pick that in. And you have to wonder if they're going to try to put all the gold on that Ringo. Taka comes off the board, was banned the last time. We're ready. It is 2-2 in a best 4 out of 7. Someone's got to get to 4 wins. We'll find out who's going to get to 3 with our casters, Action Jackson and Four Court Jester.
Well, I know who I'm rooting for. Man, these last few games have just been ridiculous.
Closest games I think I've ever done.
Absolutely. Without question for me, the closest games I've ever done. And if they keep going on like this, you know, it's going to be pretty insane. I think Team Secret's going to be happy they have the additional week before championships just to, like, take a chill pill. But let's focus on this game coming up ahead of us. I like the Taka pick. It's something you sort of mentioned you thought might come out, and I think it's perfect here.
Well, remember, at the same time, TSM have their championships first. And with it so close to this event, they said that, you know, there's going to be a very big difference of importance when it comes to this. Yeah, battling for a grudge versus battling for the top seed and $15,000, there's going to be a difference of priority. So coming into this, I'm not really surprised that they're not going outside of really their comfort range of picks. So when Taka was left open after a first pick Majestic on top of this Adagio, it kind of did make sense. It was banned last time. It won them a game already. And the big thing with this comp is, again, Majestic. You shut him down, it breaks the comp.
Absolutely, and as we saw in one of the comebacks, right, it's definitely possible that as we get to the hyper late game, even though Kvalifar's on that Ringo, not such a hyper late game carry, he can really do a lot of work just because Majestic keeps him alive. Right now, look at this. TSM, they're already being aggressive, going for some steals. I believe they did get one or two creeps there. And actually, Koldamik was thinking of just buying time for Flash to recall. I think that's what they should have done with the Kaku.
Oh, they got
Majestic
it.
First one to go down, though. So first blood to TSM, return kill to Team Secret, both the roamers disengage. It's deja vu from the last game.
Now, I'm a little curious that, you know, the laners didn't come down, but Kvalifar had his hands full there with Mixi, so there was no completion of the sandwich. So 1-1 for trade, not too bad considering it was TSM on the run from minute one, but picking it up, yeah, they went aggressive. They got a 1-1. All right, so it's not the end of the world. They can just go right back to their farming route because at this point of the game, the death timer's not so bad. And Kvalifar is just trying to make sure that he can bully around Mixi in this lane because if I'm not saying this is going to be a hyper farm, but Kvalifar on Ringo is still going to need a requisite amount of farm if he wants to hit those marks.
Yeah, absolutely. And actually, one inkling as to what's going on here might be looking at Majestic's build path. Looks like he's going for the alternating current if he decides to build more out of that attack speed.
It's very likely.
If he does that, I don't think we're going to see all of the farm on Kvalifar. No. I think this is a different style of the same composition we saw earlier.
Well, you already see that we got, you know, the Iron Guard on top of Redemption, as you would expect. So they're not trying to feed Majestic into, like, using that gold and leaving Redemption out in the cold. It's going to be a little bit more standard. And standard has sort of, I mean, we're up to a 2-2, but early game standard stuff from Team Secret is fantastic. Their late game, their ultra late game, is fantastic. It's kind of just muddling through the middle that they have to kind of figure out what they need to do.
And this is why international competition is so exciting. It's so momentous when it happens. Because
yeah, it's the clash of the regions, clash of the styles.
Yeah, if you look at EU, they like their early game, yes, you know, with the Glaive and the Kroll ganks, which we used to see a lot. But they also like their hyper late game. In the middle, not so much. I mean, they kind of just wait.
They like
15
it's
minutes,
the opposite
right?
here.
TSM, they're like early and mid. That's what they do best. So, you know, it's very exciting to see which one of these styles is going to have the edge as we move forwards. And I can't wait to see even more international competition moving forwards from this event, too.
So, Koldamik actually could be a target here, but it's Taka. You don't really get a big drop on him, especially with very little CC available to Team Secret. There's no hard stun to keep that Taka from moving, so they're not going to pick him up. Mixi is getting babysat. Should be okay-ish.
That is a lot of damage going down onto him. Look at Kvalifar tearing through the defenses there, picking up a quick kill. This is what you want to be doing with Team Secret's compositions. You got Ringo, great in the early. Adagio also does a lot of damage in the early. You amplify one another, and you are very, very strong right now. They did this well last time they played the comp, but they didn't keep the ball rolling. So hopefully for Team Secret, that's what they can continue to do.
Well, keep an eye on Taka, because past the 6, past the 7-minute mark, when I, at this point, if that's going to be a tension bow, then I'm going to have some reservations about this. But I suspect, you know, by the time that we get into an area where he has a Sorrowblade to back himself up, he's going to be a lot bigger of a target. And right now he is trying to do an invade, but he's been spotted out.
He has been spotted out, but at the same time, full health plus Kaku's could get him away. The flare blocking his exit so far from Redemption.
I love how your box can burn, you can't see it.
Yeah, and actually that was a really well-played juke coming out of Cole. He's going to be able to recall,
yep,
even though he was very close to the members of Team Secret, so he gets away with the play. Team Secret should be able to find their minion mark.
And I'm pretty sure this will be a Sora Blade first. Tension Bows, unfortunately, at least on the VGL and A side of things, anybody that went Tension Bow, if it was early Glaive, early Taka, they didn't win games. Sora Blades ended up being a much more reliable pick, so
Majestic.
We're going to have to just muddle through.
Looking for that slow, but Kvalifar didn't really follow up there. He prioritized the farm. There's a reason this guy has insane creep score, right?
If you give it to him, then he'll have it.
Exactly. But good harassment out of Majestic nonetheless. You didn't get the kill, but you forced Mixi quite low. He's not level 6 yet for the Rose defensive, so...
It's quite the wave.
Yeah, it's quite the wave.
So Kvalifar, unfortunately, he can't be too far forward, so he's not going to be able to really hit that turret. But he can poke at TSM, who is just a little bit ahead of their curve. And, ooh, Mixi, he's going to drop low. Flash, I don't think they can engage on this. Team Secret might still be able to push down and chip away more at this turret with this next creep whiff.
Well, everyone knows that Team Secret is great at pushing, and that's what they're doing right now. They're actually utilizing this combo.
Mixi!
Somewhat like that. Mixi slowed up. He's got a bit of regeneration coming across. Able to survive there with Flash X's. Fountain coming across there.
Look at Cole, though. Cole's off in the jungle. He's on a secret mission. You might be pushing the lane, but he's stealing your farm.
He is indeed, and he's doing a great job of it. So far, hasn't really been punished for this kind of play, barring that first fight, where admittedly it was even still a trade. So Team Solo Mid, they've got good answers to what Team Secret is trying to do right now.
Yep, and again, we'll have to see by the time that 12-minute mark, that magic minute, when that comes to bear, we'll have to see where we are in terms of the situation. But a little bit ago, I was going to say that, you know, Cole the Meek actually still could go into a Crystal Taka, but that point is way gone now. He's very clearly going into that Sora Blade. And so Mixi's, which means that Redemption, now that he has that fountain, probably going to go into a Pauldron next.
Yeah, I think that would be a great pickup because it actually reduces a lot of the damage coming across from their opponents.
Well, for Mixi, at any rate, Cole the Meek doesn't really care after he gets his combo done. He can just run away, reset, and the Pauldron won't matter too much, but Mixi's the more sustained threat.
Absolutely, that is a very good point. So right now, TSM, they've got some pressure in the lane, actually. TS haven't found an opportunity to turn things back and go for the kills, but they might want to change that sometime soon. You can see already Kvalifar dealing fairly insane amounts of damage with the buff up of the Agent of Wrath whenever he is able to hit one of those good targets.
They're going
but
for
here
him.
Comes TSM. They want to maybe go for a fight. Kvalifar very low. Fountain keeping him alive for the time being. Mixi first to fall, and a stun actually lands on the Flash too. Gauntlet following it up. Beautiful play out of the supports coming across from Team Secret. They do not find the kill on the Cole the Meek, but they do find the pressure. Forcing him back can be almost as good if you find a turret, and I think Kvalifar will.
Well, the minions, though. Okay. I was kind of curious. He looked like he was going to backstep into that one, but getting that kill, getting the turret, the safety net from TSM is now crunched down, and they know that there's no Taka, so picking up a gold mine, pretty free and easy at this point. I don't think Flash is going to get positioned. That being said, they're slowing down.
He's looking for it. Cole the Meek coming back, fully healed up too. They're not going to find the steal, but they could find the fight. Majestic, Kvalifar,
Flash.
Both very low. Redemption picks up the first kill. It's going to be a one for one, but Redemption, no way out of this one. Mixi should be able to get a second, and actually Cole going for the dive, picking up the third. It's an ace in exchange for one in the gold mine. Pretty even trade, but I think with the buff to the minions, the push coming across from TSM will make it in their favor.
Yep, and this turret, unfortunately, it stays numbered, and that number is measured in seconds. So with that ace, this does not make that even trade. Picking up that gold mine and and the turret. For the ace and the turret, I would definitely give that a little bit more towards TSM, because with that ace, if there was any kind of catch-up goal, and Kvalifar perhaps, because he had the three, that goes over to TSM as well.
That said, look at the gold right now. I mean, it's pretty close to even, and TS actually still have a slight edge with regards to that, even though they lost a bit more. So the advantage they had earlier on in the game is keeping them very close. Mixi face-checking here, has to use that Rose offensive to try and get out.
The infinite escape.
Yeah, Kvalifar can't stick to him there. Didn't have another Achilles to follow, so Cole the Meek's going to be fine for the time. Well, Mixi is going to be fine for the time being. Very close game in the early game, which is actually unusual, right? I mean, we've seen a lot of dominant early games and then close games as a whole, but the early games haven't been that close in so far.
All right, so again, I'm feeling like this is going to be a little bit more of a turning point. Not only did we pick up that Sorrow Blade, but now a Crystal Infusion for that Taki. He's going to be hitting like a truck right now. And again, if they can find Majestic, use the Kaku, get in. You have that triple melee, you rush him down, Majestic, you pop out that bleed, and Flash X, you know, that percentage damage. If that cashes in, you could actually see a very quick and dead Adagio from right then and there. And that could be a big launching point into this mid game for TSM.
I'd really like to see Majestic maybe get himself a reflex block, just so he can get out of these sticky situations with that more the actual shield portion of it than in fact the CC block. But at the moment, TSM going for this gold mine. This time, Team Secret not trying to contest as of yet. They are starting to make their way down. Redemption might be looking for the steal. It's very, very close.
Nope.
Doesn't find it, though. Mixi picks that one up. Here comes the Hellfire Brew. Does some decent damage. The Gauntlet going across. Kvalifar, look at the stutter stepping. He's getting so many auto attacks and finds one. Should be able... Oh, no, Cole! He gets the Kaku at the last second to get away. It looks like Flash won't be quite so lucky, but not the end of the world for TSM, trading two for the gold mine.
Yeah, but Team Secret, like, well, yeah, they'll trade out too as Flash will eventually drop, but that was everything in the bank from Team Secret, and it, you know, it packs its own punch. Between between Kvalifar getting off that stutter step, we had a terrific verse, and then that gauntlet as well. You don't really have a lot of safe spots to make a lot of this happen, and the gauntlet for the kill goes a long way, and there's a Shatterglass now on top of Majestic. So it wasn't an alternating current. He's actually very late to the party for a tier 3. But with that Shatterglass, I think they're going to put all the eggs in the Kvalifar basket.
I think that makes sense. I mean, if you look at how the fights have been going.
Look at his farm as well.
Kvalifar, he's doing great in terms of the farm, but he's also doing great in terms of the kiting. So far, Team Solo Mid haven't been able to utilize the Taka or the Black Feather to burst him. So why not just put your eggs in that basket? It makes sense.
Well, Majestic has 25 farm in 10 minutes. I'm pretty sure they're putting it in the Kvalifar basket.
Absolutely.
So he's going to be pushing 120. So with that Shatterglass,
oh, Mitchy! That could be
he's
a kill.
Burn.
The burn is going to find it. Oh, the
fountain
last second! Wow, that was extremely close.
We're taking turret shots here, but it's a 2v3. Team Secret looking for this blood.
Flash jumping in, just getting a bit of harass down. Team Secret don't want to try their luck. They're actually backing away here, playing it safe, just going for some camps. Should be able to find this healing one quite easily. And Team Solo Mid, Mixi, he's got to be counting his blessings there. Mm-hmm. Very thankful for Flash X's fountain.
Crucible now for Flash X. So Redemption, those days are numbered where those gauntlets are going to be the key turning point. So not only is it the gauntlet, but it's also that verse. You could actually go for either one. So if you're stuck inside the gauntlet, you can then use the crucible on the verse. If you're out of the verse, but you're still stuck in a gauntlet, you could use it to get out of the danger zone. So 6-4 for kills. Even gold, about 1,000 or so advantage for TSM. It keeps flip-flopping a bit, but it's still anybody's game. And that 12-minute mark comes in, and we're still dead even.
We are indeed still dead even. So it could go either way. We've seen it go both ways two times so far in this series.
2-2.
Team Secret, they are, I would argue, in the lead in terms of the pressure they're mounting on the map.
I'd agree.
I mean, they're really forcing TSM to react. But that could change at any second, so long as the vision control works well enough in the side of TSM. They're getting some good flares down here, spotting out a few attempts at the very least.
So they see TSM. The gold mine has been activated, but now it's just going to go back to its mining duties. 12 minutes. No big...
Hellfire Brew does land on Cold, does not
it's
get reflexed. Cold, but because he knows he can just Kaku away, no need really to go for any kind of crucible action there. Cole doesn't actually have his own reflex block.
So TSM didn't lose anything in that fight, but at the same time, Kvalifar, in the middle of a fight, he can't take the time to channel that Dragon's Breath, so just getting it out for the zone will reward them with a gold mine. Totally 100%, an immense gold payout for them as well. That puts them right back into about 500 between teams, and there's no real foothold from TSM here. Now they're going to be rushing in, but they're totally seen by these flares, and Team Secret saying, all right, well, we can just kite this back all day.
Yeah, and they're so close to their turrets, they should be able to get away fine here. Plus, if TSM's trying to start that minion mine, you just fight them and you have the minion mine helping you out for damage. So, not much TSM can really do in that position. Worth noting, we've got two Atlas Pauldrons now on the side of TSM. One on Mixi, one on Flash X. That is going to be very good. Actually, we have three, I'm sorry. One on Cold Meek as well.
Well, Kvalifar is the only threat.
Yes, exactly.
So you need the armor. They're going to go for as much attack speed reduction as they can. And, well, I don't think they're going to fight right in front of this turret, but TSM, they're really trying to put up this brave front so that they can control the space around the Kraken.
We were talking about how Team Secret had presence on the map earlier. TSM, at the very least, want to make motions such that it looks like they have the pressure on the map,
exactly,
right? They're trying to threaten Team Secret by moving around so much so aggressively. So far, it hasn't really resulted in much, though, and in fact, they might be losing a few minions to the minion waves as a result, so they got to be careful about letting things get away from them.
Well, it's definitely a little bit of a lull here in the action. Team Secret going to take a chance, look into the brush, but it's not really much of a chance because we did see a lot of TSM up in that lane, so they know that they can now actually go forth and, you know, put down their vision, look for their ganks. We have many infusions and a Tyrant's Monocle on top of it as well. They're going for Mixi.
Yeah, Mixi does get slowed up by the Achilles shot. Look at the damage.
Rose offensive is
that?
Not it.
Oh,
it's not
my
it.
Lord.
The cooldown was not
there. The Volifar, that was insane. He needs to kite back here, though. Try and get away from Kol'Vamik. Kol'Vamik does pick up the kill. Goes down right away afterwards. Flash very low, but Majestic doesn't have the AC. So it's going to be hard for him to stick to it, get the kill, get the ace. Even still, Team Secret, 2-1. Should be able to find a turret. Kol'Vamik, that was scary amounts of damage from that guy.
He's 3-item at this point. Turret is going to go down here as well. Flash is actually very much in danger of going down.
I mean, I think he maybe needs to be careful here. You can see Majestic putting on a bit more hurt. But if they chased that any longer, Mixi would have been back in the action. So it made sense to back away for the time being. They need to regroup with Kol'Vamik, and Kraken has to spawn. Mixi wants a piece of the action. The Majestic trying to kite back. I don't think he's going to be able to get away. He might be able to find Flash. Not quite, though.
Redemption's going
Redemption
for it.
Wants some more, trying to stick on the Flash, but he can't do it. We need Kol'Vamik to get back here, but now that
Adagio's gone,
a lot of the buff isn't there.
Oh.
Kol'Vamik, the new target, Kol'Vamik right on top of him with the X-Retsu. Team Secret
Flash is getting away.
To leave
Flash is looking.
Way
He's
earlier.
Running.
Flash, very low here, might be able to get out. The Redemption doesn't have the Vanguard. That's an Atlas Pauldron as well. Finally, Vanguard comes across.
Fountain
is there. Redemption, he is certainly not going to be picking up
ace,
the kill,
ace,
and he
ace.
Might be going
no
down.
Ace.
Trying to live, stop that ace, manages to pull it off.
Still could take Flash.
This is Flash might. Oh,
he
does
it.
Go down. Oh, my Lord. That is Redemption is
now,
just unbelievable.
No. During all this, Cole was trying to capture Kraken, nearly died for his efforts. Kraken will reset.
That's not good.
There's actual no real positioning on from either side here on top of this Kraken. Way too much time was taken down, and the loss of Flash meant no backup for that Kraken, and they lost that timer.
So, even. Right?
Feels like a similar situation, doesn't it? We've seen this now the third time in a row that nobody really wants to give up anything that they can. 16-minute mark. There's no TSM special. We have yet to see it happen once.
It is a testament to the strength of Team Secret that they have not been TSM special.
Absolutely.
Right? I mean, it really shows that they're good at defending these dicey situations. They're managing to get frequently to the late game that EU is known well for. The question is, are they going to do it this time? They got to be wary of death timers. I think that's the big mistake we saw moments ago. Kraken started here, but a flare.
Yep.
Spotting it out from Team Secret.
Everything is up for everyone.
They know what's going on here. Redemption has got Gauntlet available.
They're going.
The back of the pack is popped. TSM wanted to be the one starting, but Kol'Vamik immediately stunned. Kol'Vamik, he's got three members of the enemy team on top of him. He doesn't pick up a return kill.
Mixi.
Finally, you can see Mixi and Kol'Vamik keeping the damage going. Mixi goes down, but Cole should be able to clean up here. Redemption, no way out. Can he get the return kill again?
He's trying.
It does not look like
not
it.
This time.
TSM, they managed to pick up a big fight there. They're actually going for turrets over the Kraken.
Going for both. Flash can get it by himself. Yeah. Not going to be a problem. Kol'Vamik can easily push this in with the buffed minions and take it down. And this could actually look into a game-ending situation. But Kol'Vamik going down that early in the fight, doesn't matter that you got three items with the reflex block. If you can't survive just a little bit longer for that damage return, it's not a strategy that's going to work. So tanking out the Kraken, tanking out up against Team Secret, TSM are now putting themselves in a good spot here.
So you're Kol'Vamik, right? Put yourself in his shoes. What do you buy next? Or maybe just for Team Secret, what do you buy next to keep him safe? Because in the last two fights, he's gone down pretty fast.
Well, I think it's either going to be another Tyrant's Monocle or a Tornado Trigger. You need to get as much damage as you can per hit. And attack speed, that will get you out a little bit faster. But if you can crit harder, you might be able to just chunk down Mixi.
Because
that's how Mixi went down. He just ate so many of the shots from Kol'Vamik. But then Kol'Vamik gave it up because there wasn't enough protection.
I like the clockwork on Majestic. He's picked it up fairly late into the game and admittedly does not have much defense of his own.
Well, it's his only other item.
Yeah, it's going to be great for keeping, hopefully, Kol'Vamik in better health. Look at this. Team Secret trying to do something maybe a bit sneaky here. Playing around the edges of the vision from TSM. Going for Kol'Vamik, in fact. Achilles shot. Starting things off. That's going to be the gauntlet. Stuns Mixi. He's
taken
very low very quickly. But the Volifar gets taken lower way quicker. Majestic, he wants to go for the verse. It's not going to be enough. this time, certainly, it's going to be the TSM special. They're pushing all the way for the win. Team Secret, if they lose one more, they're done. This is what it's all about.
Whatever that 2-2 momentum that came forth from the last game, perhaps that intermission, it wore off a little bit. I mean, Lance is awesome and all, but you know, this game, it looked great too, about the 16-minute mark, and then Team SoloMid, they had that enough of their items, and they had enough focus to take down Kvalifar fast enough that you know, putting all your eggs into that one basket, that ended up being a strategy that was just too easy to counter at that point.
Well, TSM, they're now one win away from being the champions of champions. It's going to be absolutely awesome for them if they can do it. You can see a lot of the audience are really into their TSM. Of course, it is their home crowd.
Yep.
But
I can hear them from over here.
Team Secret, I mean, this has been back and forth, right? It's been, you know.